So, Beekhave or Lakeway, where are they? What are the schools like? What are the homes like? What is the difference, and where should you live? I'm Tiffany Moore. I'm a realtor right here in Austin, Texas, and I talk to a lot of people who are looking to move to Beekhave or Lakeway, but they're not sure what's the difference, where these cities are even located, are they cities or are they just neighborhoods? So today we're going to get into all of those details. So one thing that I tell people is that Beekhave and Lakeway really remind me of California. There's rolling hills, there's canyons everywhere, trees, it's very close to the water. It's very California-esque without the $2 million price tag, so it's a nice bargain. So first, let's talk about where Beekhave and Lakeway are at. If you're looking at the map, from downtown Austin, Beekhave is gonna be west. It's about a 30-minute drive if you're going at like noon on a Wednesday to get to downtown Austin. If you're going during rush hour, it's gonna be more like 45 or 50 minutes to get downtown. In Lakeway, you take the same road that you get to Beekhave, and then you just keep going a little bit north and you are gonna hit Lakeway. So Lakeway is more like a 40-minute drive to downtown Austin, but during rush hour, it's going to be closer to an hour. So as far as the neighborhoods go, I like to use a resource called niche.com to kind of get their overall rating for the neighborhoods. Both Lakeway and Beekhave have an A+ rating. They're both rated A+s on the schools, but then I dug deeper and got ratings for the specific schools in that area. So I really like to use Great Schools. .org. It's a cool resource that'll give you not only like the school's ratings, but it's going to tell you about their testing, their diversity, their college prep, all that good stuff. So if you are not familiar with that, I highly recommend it if you're interested in being in a good school district. So both Beekhave and Lakeway schools are in the Lake Travis School District, which is one of the better school districts in Austin. The best is probably Eanes School District, E-A-N-E-S. So Eanes School District has 8 out of 9 schools that rank at an 8 or higher, and Lake Travis has 4 schools out of 9 that rank at an 8 or higher. So Lake Travis is a good school district, but it is not the best. Eanes is gonna be a little bit closer to downtown in like the Rollingwood area. That's where you're gonna find the best schools in Austin. So for Beekhave, the elementary schools are Beekhave and Lake Point. Beekhave is rated a 7 and Lake Point is rated a 9. So in Lakeway, the elementary schools are Serene Hills and Lakeway. Those are both rated a 9, and Lake Travis is rated a 6. For middle school, the middle school in Beekhave is Lake Travis. It's rated a 6. And in Lakeway, it's Hudson Bend. That's rated an 8. For high school, both Beekhave and Lakeway go to Lake Travis High, and that's rated a 7. So let's talk about housing prices in Beekhave versus Lakeway and what you get for your dollar in each of those neighborhoods. So Lakeway is closer to the water. It's the main drive of why people want to live in the area, is to do all the fun water sports and just go chill or go sailing. That's the main reason that someone is going to live in Lakeway. So in January of 2021, the median home sales price in Lakeway was $727,000. So that is a 25% increase from January of 2020. There were only a few home sales in Lakeway. That's why that number is so huge, that 25%. But just to give you an idea of the property value in Lakeway, it is one of the most desirable places in Austin to live if you want to be somewhere with like beautiful topography, if you want to be close to the water. It's very family friendly, lots of stuff to do with kids and things like that. So Lakeway is very sought after, and it's one of the higher priced areas in Austin. So for Beekhave in January 2021, the median sales price for homes was $620,000, and that's a 6% increase over January of 2020. So the area, especially Beekhave, has been priced pretty high overall. So it's going pretty steady. 6% is like the lowest percentage increase that I have seen so far this year. Most of their neighborhoods are at least at like a 10 or 11% increase from January 2020 to January 2021. That is not to say that buying a home in Beekhave is not a good investment. It's such a solid investment. Like anywhere that you buy in Austin, your property value is going to continue to appreciate just because of the nature of the economy here, all the jobs that are moving here, and just the trajectory that Austin has been on for literally decades. So let's talk about taxes. If you've watched any of my other videos, then you know that you need to be keenly aware of the tax rate in Austin. So Texas doesn't have state income taxes. Instead, we have property taxes. So the tax rate in Beekhave and Lakeway is pretty comparable, but Beekhave is a little bit lower. So for homes that are on the market now, the tax rate varies between 1.89 and 2.48. And that 2.48 is in the new construction neighborhoods. So new construction is usually going to have a higher tax rate than older homes, mostly due to the infrastructure that they had to put in to build those communities. Usually there's no schools going in. Also, there are just fewer residents in that community to pay all the taxes. So your tax rate is going to be higher until those communities start getting filled out, maybe 7 to 10 years down the road. And so the tax rate for homes on the market right now in Lakeway is 1.97 to 2.9. And again, that 2.9 is in the newer construction communities. So basically what this means is if you buy a home that's assessed to be valued at $700,000 and your tax rate is 2.5, your annual tax bill is going to be about $17,500. So if you break that down per month, which is usually what mortgage companies do, it's going to be about an extra $1,500 a month that you need to budget for when you're trying to plan how much house can I afford. So let's look at some of the neighborhoods that are in these communities. In Beekhave, we've got Falcon Head and Falcon Head West. They are kind of older communities built 10, 15 years ago. They're really, really pretty. They've got beautiful landscaping. All the yards are very well maintained. There's golf courses everywhere. It's just really, really pretty. But it is kind of in a flatter area of Beekhave. Another neighborhood that I really like a lot is called Provence. It's set in like the hilly area. The topography is really pretty. It's like cliffs and views everywhere. Obviously, you're going to pay for those views. So with new construction, you pay a lot premium for all the fancy lots, corner lots, big lots, lots with views. You're definitely going to pay for some lots with views. I had a customer that was looking in Provence in December, and there's this gorgeous lot with a view that had like a $75,000 lot premium for it, because that is why you live in Hill Country, is for the views and everything. So anyway, Provence is just a gorgeous new community with really beautiful homes, gorgeous topography, lots of trees. It's one of my favorite places in Beekhave right now. And Lakeway is really interesting. So there's like older Lakeway and the new construction Lakeway. Two of the new construction neighborhoods that I really love are Rough Hollow and Sweetwater. Sweetwater is humongous. You're driving down 620, which is the main road out in Lakeway, and it's just like block after block after block of these signs that are just like, Sweetway, turn, Sweetwater, turn here, and Sweetwater, turn over here, and this neighborhood is still Sweetwater, and you haven't left Sweetwater yet. It's just, it's huge. They have a ton of pools, a ton of cool amenities, and it is set in the topography, so you've got the hills and everything. It doesn't just look like a big, flat, planned neighborhood. It's really, really pretty. And Rough Hollow is actually waterfront, and it's the same. It's very hilly. Lots of winding roads, lots of homes on different levels, just kind of overlooking the area. Just a really, really gorgeous community with a bunch of different home styles and home sites available out there. So those are the two communities that I really, really love in Lakeway that are new construction. So what is there to do in Beekhave? What do you do if you live there? Beekhave, you'll see in the stuff that we talk about, is a lot of like land fun, lots of stuff to do on the land, and Lakeway is a lot of water fun. One of the cool parks in Beekhave is Beekhave Central Park. It's 50 acres. It's got a lot of like open space just for running around, playing, having a picnic, lots of picnic tables, playgrounds, things like that. It's just a really great place to just walk around, be in nature, and enjoy being outside in this amazing, beautiful setting. So there's also the Beekhave Sculpture Garden, which is kind of a hidden gem in Beekhave. A lot of people don't even know it's there. It's just outside of the police station, and it's 7 acres of sculptures. Some of them are permanent, some of them are rotating. Just a really cool place to walk around, kind of take your mind off of things. It's right outside of the Galleria, so you can go from shopping and restaurants to kind of being in this peaceful, quiet, serene setting and just taking your mind off of things. So due to the topography and the hills and everything, there are a ton of hiking and biking trails in Beekhave. It's one of the most fun things to do out there. If you're going to the Galleria, you can easily like drive a couple miles and all of a sudden be on a hiking and biking trail. So it's a really fun place to go if you just want to be in nature. You don't just want to be on the flat land the whole time. Beekhave is definitely somewhere if you're looking to hike, bike, be in nature, and just see really pretty surroundings. And then you've got the Galleria. So the Galleria is tons of shops and restaurants. It's like the epicenter in Bee Cave. Across the street from it, there's a huge grocery store. Like everything that you need to do, you can either do it at the Galleria or right across the street from it. It's where all of the businesses are in Bee Cave. So we talked about the fun in Lakeway being water fun. There are a ton of hike and bike trails because of the topography, it being so hilly, and a lot of people who live out in the area just want to be outside and be in nature. So there are a ton of hike and bike trails, but that is not the main drive to Lakeway. Folks who live in Lakeway live out there because they want to be close to the water. So if you own a boat, there are a lot of public access spots where you can get onto Lake Travis. One of them is City Park and the other is Lakeway Marina. So those are places where you can go and put your boat in and just enjoy the day out there. If you don't own a boat, but you just enjoy being at one, there's a ton of places where you can rent a boat either like on a daily basis, or you can join a membership where you have like access to like X boats per month or per year. You can split it with other families or other couples, and that way you can just go out on the lake whenever you want, but not really have to worry about the maintenance or the storage of a boat. So that's another option as well, is renting a boat whenever you want it, or doing like a membership style renting. Also, in addition to like speed boats that everyone thinks of when you're like water skiing or tubing, things like that, there's a lot of sailing in Lakeway. So if you own a sailboat, you can just take your boat out and go for a beautiful sail. You can learn how to sail. They have sailing classes in Lakeway. Or if you don't want to deal with any of that and you just want someone to take care of everything for you, you can just charter a sailboat for the afternoon or for the evening, go out for like a sunset ride, bring a little cooler with you. It's so pretty. Like the area out there is just gorgeous. And that is why you want to live in Lakeway. So you have easy access to it. You can go out there whenever you want, whether it's on your own boat or someone else's boat, or someone just does everything for you. And if you are just a little bit more analog or a little bit more introverted, you can totally put your canoe or your kayak or your stand-up paddle in the water at a ton of different places, or rent one to just use for the day. Lakeway and Bee Cave are some of the coolest areas in Austin. If you want to be in nature, if you want to go hiking or biking or be on the water, if you want good schools and you want homes that have really good values and whose values are going to continue to appreciate, these are definitely neighborhoods that I recommend.